tú.
Yeah.
Yeah. 16 after this.
Juan Reiner?
You lost, man? We didn't call for a waiter.
I've got orders to find you, from Meyer and the commander. And my name's...
I know who you are, Aiden. After that bang-up with the renegades, half the canteen wants to name their most precious offspring after you. Including Vinny here. But you interrupted our meal. State your purpose in one sentence, then please... make yourself scarce.
Well, you know perfectly well why I'm here. The UV lamps. Meyer says you owe the peacekeepers a delivery.
And you think your barking will make an impression on me? The Lummox in Chief Jack thinks he can scent his terrier, and everyone will wet themselves in terror. But what can I expect? He can't tell the difference between champagne in a crystal chalice or water from a dog's bowl. He hasn't an ounce of refinement. Isn't that right, Vinny?
I don't know.
Don't be afraid. It's not like Jack is gonna march in and have you hanged. At least not now. Ah, Vinny. When will you grow a spine? You want my attention, Aiden? Show me you deserve it. What can you offer me?
How about a court-martial? Matt can do that, right?
A court-martial? You have no idea who you're talking to, do you? Who would hash out the contracts with the suppliers? Who would feed the army, provide it with weapons and clothing? A week without me, and the peacekeepers will be left with nothing. Supply is everything. Try again, man. And don't improv this time.
All right, listen. I'm just trying to help. I need those lamps.
So the groveling and begging begins. My favorite part. You really need them? Or Jack? What'd he promise you?
Look, you were supposed to deliver, and I was asked to make sure you do.
And how do you expect to do that? Maybe bat your pretty eyelashes at me? I'm not saying you're not my type, because you are. But I need a reason to break Vinny's heart for someone else. So, you have to try harder.
Huh. Okay.
You've used up all your time. Didn't pique my interest.
Look, what is it you want, Juan?
Like they used to say, if you gotta ask the price, you can't afford it. Turning to more pressing matters.
And?
What should we try next?
Did you make headway with the pompous ass?
Never met a guy quite like him before.
I told you. Come see me back at my place. We'll talk.
Even a drop of Pinot. Maybe some fruit. Sweet.
Let me guess. He scarfed down 5 courses and had a hot young woman at his side.
A young man, but the rest is accurate.
He's a piece of work, all right.
Well, I need him to get back to work. Jack needs UV lamps and Juan's dragging his feet.
That'll be tough. Juan barely listens to Jack, so he'll be an even tougher audience for you. He has his own men and power base, and he loves rubbing Jack's nose in that.
And what can I do about that?
Same as everyone else. Bribe him. He likes fine art, antiques, expensive shit from before the fall. When he sees something that used to be valuable, he can't stop himself. Zero self-control.
All right, where can I find something like that?
I heard of an old Polish guy who lived in a penthouse by Liberation Passage. They say he was an art collector. You can try his place. You can only get there via paraglider. That's why there's a chance something is left. I'll be on the radio and guide you to him.
What about you, huh? Going on a hunt?
No, a party. It's Danier's birthday, but you never know when a guest list will overlap with a hit list. Why don't you come and have a drink with us when you're done with one?
I don't think Danier likes me.
He doesn't like anybody. We'll be in touch. Go, find some art.
Get over here and check this stuff. What the heck can I do for you? That's some good shit right there. You sure can rely on that. Tell your buddies, if they ain't too, prepare to be a customer for life.
It's like, ain't nothing I won't sell you, honey. Y'all come back now, you hear?
Welcome, valued customer. Now I gotta go restock my shelves. Have I got some merch for you?
Still feeling sick?
Everyone's more for the time.
Just
mention anyone.
Don't.
You look
worry.
Not well, Senor Anton.
Senor Anton.
Renegades check canteen.
Not well, Senor Antonio.
Follow their trail. Scout out the situation first.
You got a problem?
Yeah, but too dangerous to pull anyone else into.
Come on, just out with it already.
Okay. Have a seat. I'll tell you the whole story. My name's Paul. I run a damn good scavenger team. Me and Daisy are in charge. Her son Fitz is our second. Recently, some assholes moved into our territory, trying to push us out. Avery and Francis. You heard of them? No? Well, they're bad fucking news. Daisy went to talk to him to be neighborly. Our neighbors beat her and broke her hand. It could have been worse. Even after that, we were willing to talk. I mean, we're not fighters. So Fitz took the crew with him for another meeting yesterday. They never came back. And I don't know what to do. I need to find them. I need to know what happened.
I see. Okay, I can take a look. Where do I start?
You're a godsend. The team must have left from our staging area. Back in the day, it was called the Incubate Building near Goldstone Loans. The signs are still up, so you shouldn't have trouble finding it. Just take a look. I'll make it worth your while. Promise.
I'll check it out, and we'll see.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry. I thought she...
You're Daisy, right? Is anyone else here? Paul sent me. He's been worried about you, Fitz, and your team. Where is everyone?
At the Larrabee building, on Milton Court. Not far from here, by the modern art sculpture. Fitz and Francis arranged to meet there. Francis seems more civilized than his brother Avery. But ask me.
Yeah.